Should you be sacrificing your personal style for first impression? If you have ever asked yourself this question, trust me, you are not alone. Hi, I'm Sylvie Di Giusto, and today we are going to be getting into Lisa's question about if she should stick with her authentic style or dress up a bit more for a first impression. For those who are new here, I specialize in people packaging. Yeah, that's right. I'm here to help you make the best first impression possible for your next interview, presentation, business meeting, or whatever the occasion may be. When it comes to creating your ideal appearance for a first impression, it is essential to consider your personality. Because if you are not representing yourself in a way that you are comfortable, it will show through in the way you are behaving. So, yes, it is important to stay authentic to yourself. But you can be authentic while still dressing up your current look a bit more. We all carry different image personas within us, kind of a DNA, regardless of our gender, race, or age. While most of us have styles and looks that feel the most comfortable, it is common for us to shift those depending on the circumstances. However, I totally get that it can sometimes be hard to identify the right styles that will feel like yourself while still coming off as a professional and current. That's why I launched a new image persona assessment on my website. The idea behind it is to help people identify how others may perceive them based on that DNA. By getting personalized information about how you may be perceived by the specific clothing styles you tend to lean towards, ways you would usually behave, or choices you make, you can better navigate planning for your desired first impression. For example, when Lisa wrote to me about this question, she mentioned that she usually likes to wear a nice jacket, heels, and dark jeans. That is her comfort zone. If Lisa would take the assessment, chances are high she would fall under the explorer. People who match with the explorer usually like to keep it casual and comfortable. They are those casual and sporty next-door neighbors with an easygoing, friendly, always fun and optimistic personality. We love to be around them. They usually have a good sense of humor and are spontaneous on the one hand and laid back on the other hand. Each image persona has two sides, good and bad, easy and hard, worry free and challenging. There is no right or wrong. The explorer therefore struggles with sometimes being perceived as too casual, too laid back, not being a go-getter, and hard to fit into a corporate environment. Now, you are right. These may all be just assumptions about a person like Lisa. However, these assumptions are subconsciously made about you by people imprinting their opinions about you based on your appearance, behavior, and communication. Your appearance plays a significant role in this, as it's like a filter you put in front of you. People think you are casual because you might look casual. The colors you choose, the fabrics, the patterns, the fits and cuts, they all play a role. However, this is simply your primary image persona, meaning your go-to image that you are most likely to be in and you are most likely born with. Your primary and somehow natural persona, if you will, is the one you should never try to change, adjust, or let go of. Someone who is categorized to be an explorer, for example, should never try to fit into the concepts of a traditionalist. And vice versa. It would make you feel uncomfortable, insecure, and anxious. A lack of self-confidence and faith in oneself and its abilities is the consequence, as well as being perceived as someone who is inauthentic, playing a role, or not have found your true self yet. It's just part of who you are. Accept it, stick with it, and even develop and expand it. But all of us have a primary and a secondary identity. And by finding out your secondary persona, it can provide some insight into how we can up our appearance without straying too far out of your comfort zone. This is exactly what this assessment will tell you. By honing in on your primary and secondary image persona, you will get a better idea of how people perceive you and how you can alter your image to be genuinely you and still incredibly professional. If you have ever felt unsure about how you come across in a first impression based on your attire, go take the assessment linked below. And as always, for any further questions that you would like to have answered on my YouTube channel, please feel free to get in touch and I will feature your question here. It can be incredibly challenging to navigate a first impression. Thanks for taking the time to improve yours.